get down to the coin toss down. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The Bulldogs and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
It's hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. So it's 2nd and 10, ball on the 26-yard line. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Tackles him hard at the 18-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
It's 2nd and 2. Ball on the 50-yard line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
From the 39-yard line, it's 2nd down. Play action. He's going to go for the home run. It's picked off. It's the junior. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 23-yard line.
It's a good play when the corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
From their own 23-yard line, 1st down. Makes it, and the quarterback scrambles. He's going to take off. Slides down to the ground.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
Missed tackle. Gets out to around the 45. It's 2nd down now, and they're just a few feet away from that 1st down marker. They'll bring him down right around the 44-yard line.
Hey,
they'll bring him down behind the line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, we've got a player down, and let's hope that's nothing serious. And this one is a beauty. And down he goes at the 32. Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on their own 36. And they push him out right around the 40. Hand off and he won't make it. He really got a hold of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Made around the 23-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 23. They come out in an empty backfield. There's a strike complete. And he's taken down at about the 29-yard line. The middle for a nice game. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. He's taken down around the 45-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
We've played one. Still no score. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. And down he goes at the 47. From their own 47-yard line. First down. And he's tackled at about the 45.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series. Make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
He steps out at about the 47-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Complete, he's out of bounds.
Colts. What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
This is the ninth play of this drive.
How the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive, and you just want to get the ball in his hands.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 21. Here's the halfback. He has some room. He goes out of bounds at about the 11. Here's the 11th play of the drive. That brings in second and 9. Hands it off. He's tackled at about the 9-yard line.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense, and look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
Tackle right around the 14-yard line. That brings him second and goal. From the 14-yard line, second down. He gets another carry, and they make the stop at the 14-yard line. Here's play number 14 of this drive. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And he can't get away from the pressure. That brings us fourth and goal. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. He gets it up, and he's got it. Like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. The corner, and he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and goal.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. And they fall on the loose ball. To the 20. Gains his way to the 13-yard line. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And great awareness by the defense to jump on.
Tough break for the offense. They lose it on a backward pass. A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
About 2 minutes before halftime. Off to the left, and they wrestle him down behind the line. Quick pass. Brought down at the 9-yard line. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
It's up, and the field goal is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up to take a few chances.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Steps out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. It's second down and eight. Ball on the 27. Just throws this one away. To about the 41-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give them a first down. Linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. Out of bounds, right around the 48-yard line. Here's an opening. He's pushed out of bounds at the 37. From the 37-yard line, first down. Out of bounds, right around the 30.
That makes it second and two.
And he is drilled at the 26. The pass is complete for 4 yards, and that'll be a first down.
I'll tell you, these guys just keep rolling down the field. Quarterback's looking very sharp on this drive.
Slings it. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
Yeah, the defense looked a little sluggish there, and they can do better than that.
Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the referee signals for a touchdown again. He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 38-yard line.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. Only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Throws it in a hurry. The Bulldogs call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, just a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Quick strike to the receiver. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks away, and it sails right on him. No good.
All it takes is a split second of something going wrong. A low snap, a bad hold, a slip, and you've got a miss to the right or the left.
The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
He's going to go for the home run. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. We've played a half. The Wildcats lead 7-6.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He sends this one deep. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again.
Yeah, let's go set lunch.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. From their own 29-yard line. It's second down. They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's at the 40. He's at the 30 for the 20. And they finally make the stop at the 9-yard line. Capitalize on the big run. It's now first and goal. It's the tailback. They bring him down in the backfield.
Two times.
He's out of bounds around the 9-yard line. It's third down, and they come up to the line about 9 yards away from the end zone. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's taken down at the 1-yard line. Stuff. Football will change hands as they fail to convert on fourth down. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He's taken down at the 3. It's second down. This is a dangerous situation, backed up against their goal line. There's a strike complete, and down he goes at about the 17-yard line. Makes it out to about the 17-yard line. From their own 17-yard line. Second down. Up the middle for a nice gain. Down the catch, and he's got room here. And he tackles him hard at the 32-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space, and he hits him hard at the 40. This is the 8th play of this drive. They push him out around the 44-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 44. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
That'll bring up fourth and 9.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. Lack of offense or great defense, call it what you will. We head to the fourth quarter. The Wildcats lead it by one. This final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. Now he tries to buy some time. Looks like he's going to run. So the scramble goes for 9 yards. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He scrambled. He gets sacked on the play. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and cause him some problems.
This is the 15th play of this drive. Complete. He's got room. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game.
The middle linebacker came on a blitz, which can be very disruptive. Sometimes a quarterback will get happy feet when they see that coming. But not this guy. He's very composed and can deliver under a pass rush.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He fights forward to about the 7. This is the 17th play of this drive. He's in! Touchdown! And they take the lead. Touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the 2-point conversion. And they won't get the 2. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, I can say this much, Kirk, at least it's tight in the fourth quarter.
Well, it is a close game, and neither team's been able to get anything going, whether it's running the football or throwing, and look up at the scoreboard, and at least, as you said, Brad, it's a close game. Who can make a play late to win it?
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. That's a great tackle at the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line. First down. Give to the tailback. Brought down around the 41-yard line. That makes it second. Out of bounds at about the 41. Third and long. This defense digs in here, and it could be their ball game. Less than 3 minutes in the game. to go long and does. And he makes the catch. Tackle right around the 14-yard line. It's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. And they'll get him in the backfield. Third and long here in the fourth, and this is the biggest third down of the ball game. They'll spread the field with five wide. He's pushed out of bounds at the 10. You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens? There are 2 minutes to go in this football game. Over the middle to his tailback. Touchdown, and they take the lead. Thank you. You don't really gain anything by kicking the extra point here, so they'll go for two and try to go up by three. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
The kicker will stay on the sidelines for this extra point as the offense is going to stay on the field and try to make this a three-point game. They don't get it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Bulldogs coaching staff and the entire team knows that this is the guy that can win it for them.
The offense has to find a way to get the football into the hands of this running back, whether it's a simple toss sweep or maybe a ball out of the backfield where he can catch it in space. Any way that they can get the football to him to see if he can spring one to maybe get the field goal range, or who knows, maybe take it to the house.
Throws left, picked off. Got an opening. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. I tell you what, this is something Pollock would love. Crunch time in a defensive battle.
Well, he's sitting back at that studio loving this. Two defenses that are really imposing their will on these two offenses. Maybe they can even score to help out one of these offenses win the game.
Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Just under two to go in the game. He's going to try and scramble. It's on the ground. And they make the stop at the 18. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Caught with room to work. And he is drilled at the 28-yard line. He heaves it deep. And he hauls it in deep downfield. Tackle made at the 14-yard line. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
And he shoved out of bounds at the 14. The halfback lucky to get anything on that toss play. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 14. They'll bring him down around the 13-yard line. Pick up of a yard for the tailback. The Bulldogs call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Flips it middle to the running back. And down he goes around the 9-yard line. This is their last chance. They need a big play here. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game. big, big conversion right here. Time is running out, and they need this one to tie it up. We have less than a minute to go. Gets it on the pitch. They got it.
That was a huge, huge conversion. Maybe there's more excitement in store for us in regulation, but if it doesn't happen, we get to go to overtime.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. And he's tackled right around the 38-yard line. It out. He's taken down at the 9. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
And it pays off. Touchdown. The play clock's at 0. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
And he hits the PAT. Surprised that they just squib it here. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one. Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. It's scooped up, and it's a lineman that's got it. Spikes the ball. They really need to pick up this third and long here in the fourth quarter. For all of you watching, it's been a great game, and it has a chance to be even greater. Will the prayer be answered? It's time for the Hail Mary. He chucks it downfield. Almost intercepted. A great game here today in a tight one. 27-20, Wildcats. So that wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.